space exploration has often been used as a proxy competition for geopolitical rivalries, such as the Cold War. The early era of space exploration was driven by a space race between the Soviet Union and the United States. The launch of the first human-made object to orbit Earth, the Soviet Sputnik 1, on 4th of October 1957, and the first moon landing by the American Apollo 11 mission on the 20th of July 1969 are often taken as landmarks for this initial period. The Soviet space program achieved many of its first milestones, including the first living being in orbit in 1957. The first human space flight, Yuri Gagarin, aboard the Vostok 1 in 1961. The first spacewalk by Alexei Leonov on 18th of March 1965. The first automatic landing on another celestial body in 1966. And the launch of the first space station, the Salut 1, in 1971. After the first 20 years of exploration, focus shifted from one-off flights to renewable hardware, such as the Space Shuttle program, and from competition to cooperation, as with the International Space Station, the ISS. In the early 2000s, the People's Republic of China initiated a successful manned space flight program, while the European Union, Japan, and India have also planned future crewed space mission. China, Russia, Japan, and India have advocated crewed mission to the moon during the 21st century, while the European Union has advocated manned mission to both the moon and Mars during the 20th and 21st century. The Europeans and Asians are extremely future-oriented and looks 200 to 300 years ahead, and uses those projections to operate in the current world. An example of this can be seen in science fiction. As the name implies, science fiction involves speculations about current happenings in science and oftentimes about the future. Do you find it hard to imagine space stations located in Africa and African men and women flying through space, establishing satellites in cities? Many will find this unrealistic, as it doesn't seem real. But when H.G. Wells and Burns were writing about flights to the moon and the time machine, the Europeans hadn't traveled to the moon. Man resembles God, and because he's like God, he thinks and creates like God. He creates first through imagination, fantasy, images, and manipulation of symbols. And then the symbols become a reality. In other words, a visualization of the fantasy occurs first. When you rob a people of their imagination, when you dare not leap beyond your current realities and visualize, then you will not be able to create into reality those things that are necessary to advance you as a people or as a group. And until we can fire the minds of our children with science fiction, then we only continue to lag behind in scientific advancement. To master this world, we must fictionalize, visualize, so that our young ones can build and bring into reality. In the future, wars will be fought in space, and the people who cannot conquer space and ultimately protect themselves from it will be defeated and destroyed. The United States officially launched its first Star Wars program, called the Strategic Defense Initiative, SDI, in 1983 during the Ronald Reagan administration. In 2018, President Donald Trump launched the Space Force as the sixth arm of the United States Armed Forces. In 2015, Russian Air Force and the Russian Aerospace Defense Forces were meshed together to form the Russian Aerospace Forces, which re-established the Russian Space Force as one of its three sub-branches. Space Force program is reality, and those nations who will not be able to defend themselves in space will be subjugated. And this is what African education in the future must address, not equality here on Earth, because this will be going out in style. There are a few African science fiction authors like Nnedi Okorafor, Tomi Adeyemi, Samuel L. Dineni, Octavia Butler, Nano Hopkins, and Mr. Front and others. But we still need more authors in this genre to inspire the next generation of Africans. So far, no single African country has a space force, but a few have space program and satellites. After decades of playing catch-up, the African Union decided to join the global space race. The AU passed legislation to establish the African Space Agency in 2017 and approved Egypt as host country for the headquarters of the new agency. Nigeria and South Africa both have the most advanced space program on the continent, and they are in a race to put the first African in space by 2030. Article 8 of the statute of the African Space Agency states that high-level experts should be elected by the assembly from persons of high moral character, qualification, experience in their respective countries. Most of the people who have the skills and experience of working on a space program are in the diaspora. And for that reason, we advise that the African Space Agency work closely with successful Africans, such as Astier Tribi Olumu, who is a Ghanaian robotics engineer at the National Aeronautic and Space Administration, NASA, and the chief engineer and technical group leader for the Nobility and Manipulation Group at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. He has been associated with various NASA Mars missions, notably the Mars Rover and InSight projects. Avi Klutzes is also a rocket scientist of Ghanaian descent, a US civil servant, and a complex system engineer and design expert, and a senior NASA spacecraft system engineer. Dr. Sheikh Modibo Diarra is a Malian astrophysicist who studied mathematics, physics, and analytical mechanics in Paris at the University of Pierre and Marie Curie. He then received a master's in aerospace engineering and a PhD in mechanical engineering, both from Howard University in Washington, D.C. He was recruited by Caltech Jet Propulsion Laboratory, a NASA federally funded research and development center under a contractor with the California Institute of Technology, Caltech, where he played a role in several NASA programs, including the Magellan probe to Venus, the Ulysses probe to the Sun, the Galileo spacecraft to Jupiter, and the Mars Observer and the Mars Pathfinder. Dr. Eni Gerard Njoku is retired as a senior research scientist from the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, Pasadena, California, in 2016. After a career in the development of satellite microwave system for Earth observation, he now consults on remote sensing and writes on a variety of subjects of technical and commercial and public interest. While at the GPL, he was the project scientist for the SMAP, this is the Soil Moisture Active Passion mission launched in 2015 that studied Earth's surface water distribution. He currently holds an appointment as GPL Research Associate. The African Space Agency can develop an astronaut program that can work closely with experienced African-American astronauts such as Robert Stacher, Leonard DeMelvey, Alvin Drew, Joanne Hinglebottom, and Stephanie Williams. At the end of the Cold War and the space race, a new rationale was made on the pragmatic use of space for improving life on Earth, with notable utilities such as satellite telecommunication, remote sensing, microgravity research, and satellite navigation. Government space program began investing in practical outcomes for the public good. Therefore, the importance of measuring the socio-economic benefits of space activities steadily grew throughout the 1970s and 80s, an era defined as Mission to Planet Earth. These benefits continue into today's society as the privatization of space and space exploration continues to show scientific and socio-economic benefits to those around them. Space program have generated a wide range of hardware, software, and processes that have made their way into a myriad of applications. The benefits of these applications are directly attributable to the original investments made by the space agency, as well as the private sector. Space exploration alone has provided a significant amount of knowledge that is important for the education of people about basic understanding of the planet and the universe. Some of the more direct benefits of space exploration include an increase in the knowledge that is out there about space and the discovery of distant planets and galaxies. It gives us insight into the beginning of our universe. Thank you. Like, share, and subscribe.